वेलकम टू हाइड्रिक स्टडी पार्क। लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड पैरामीटराइज्ड व्यू कंट्रोलर। ओके, पैरामीटराइजेबल व्यू कंट्रोलर। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न मल्टी एक्शन कंट्रोलर, मल्टी एक्शन कंट्रोलर। ओके, दिस इज द वीडियो नंबर सेशन नंबर 18 एंड लास्ट वीडियो। वन टाइम आई रिकॉल पैरामीटराइज्ड व्यू कंट्रोलर वी कंप्लीटेड एंड आल्सो वी शोन वन we discuss one example on the basis of parameterized view controller. One time I want to execute this program, one time for the newly joined guys. Okay, for the new students, those are watching the video or the separately in a YouTube, so please watch the last video, say session number 17. In the session number 17, all the step-by-step process I have discussed in the last video. So go and watch it. Just I am showing the output of this program. And if you want this code, follow my page, iTrick Study Park, iTrick Coding Park, is my page name. There you will get this code. Okay. Now let's see. Yeah, this one, the AR is the page name is there. Okay. So now here you can click about us. Okay, and just this is the my mail ID. About us, or you can mail me, okay, directly. If you have any doubt, you can mail me directly. Okay, just contact us. This is the contact us. iTrick Study Park is the channel, YouTube channel. There you are watching this video. So now let's see. This is the last class example, guys. We completed. So now today's topic is very, very important topic is, what is the topic name is? Topic name is, just close this. And topic name is, one thing is I want to show you. Last class, we given some some controller class hierarchy I have given to you, based command controller having these many four controllers are also there. Okay, after multi action controller I will discuss this. Okay, after that I will discuss base command controller. Okay, and parameterized view controller, as you know guys, where you use the main intention of parameterized controller, it won't support the form submission data. It's only generate the dynamic content, guys. Okay, multi-action controller. Okay, so now multi-action controller is, guys, like suppose if you have multiple actions, suppose update delete save and search of these options you have, you want to perform these action on a particular operations. Okay, so now there is no other suggestions are there, like you can do. Otherwise we can do only one thing, create a different controller, like save controller first you create, and update controller you create, and delete controller you create, and search controller you create. Okay, these four to five, if you have 15 actions, if you have 15 actions, then you should create 15 controller classes. So this is the increased burden of the application. So overcome this burden. So multi-action controller come into the picture next. So okay. So one by one, I will light at some point. Okay, then you can understand. So main intention is this only. We here by using multi-action controller, by using single controller. Just use multi-action controller in your application, and you can declare n number of handler methods. Okay, so now here topic is multi action control. Okay, one thing is I want to highlight it. In this topic, multi action controller, we developed mini project. Okay, what is the mini project? Like CRUD operations. Okay, so today's is total introduction part. Okay, so don't skip the video. If you skip this video, then you cannot understand single point of the next development. Okay, next sessions. So two sessions I will take to complete this project. 2 or 3 sessions I will take. Okay, to complete. Back to that, teaching one by one and slowly with the theory and practicals. Okay, so I will complete. So don't skip this also and put more concentration here. Okay, also I will use JDBC template more. Why? Because I am interested. I will use what is that? Oracle database. Okay, I will use Oracle database. Okay, so for that Oracle database, for that I will use JDBC template. I will not use simple JDBC on JPA and some other reason. I will use the JPA also. Okay, so up to that I will use JDBC template provided by the Spring framework. So now is also I will not use annotation totally this project based on XML base. This project is mini project based on, okay, I'm writing. Is mini project based on only XML configuration. Okay, this mini project based on only XML configuration. Okay, so now let's start our multi-action. So now try to understand. Okay, so now in general in Spring MVC applications, Spring MVC application, we will prepare a separate controller class depending on our requirement. Okay, requirement, depending our requirement, we developed other separate controllers. Okay, so now the next point is, in the above problem, this is the approach, if we want to provide a particular particular entity related actions, related actions like save, update, these method I will perform. Okay, search and delete. This is the CRUD operation, huh? delete, then we have to prepare, it's our responsibility to prepare a separate controller classes like support, save controller, I said it, na? Save controller, comma, update controller. Update controller and etc. Okay. Any more you can declare of it. It will increase. Increase number of controller classes. Okay. It will increase the number of classes. So now, next is in the above context to reduce number of controller classes. Spring framework has provided an alternative within the form of one class is the org.springframework.web.servlet.mbc.multi-action controller. Okay. So now in this form, Spring Framework provides a solution for this. Okay. So now, main point of the multi-action controller. Write it. The main intention of multi-action action controller. Multi-action controller class is to group related actions
into single controller.
This is the main intention, guys. What is the multi-action intention? The group related actions into a single controller. Okay. This is the main intention, guys. If you want to use multi-action controller controller class in Spring MVC application, Spring Web MVC or MVC, you can understand. Okay, I think you can understand now. Google 18 session is going on, guys. Okay, Spring MVC, then we have to declare an user defined class as subclass to multi action controller, and we have to define okay, so define action method with the same incoming URI names. Now what is the point in if you want to use multi-action control class in Spring application, then we have to declare one user defined class as a subclass to multi action controller, and we have to define action method with the incoming URI name. Okay, now how all these things I will give. So, but this is the prototype, guys. I'm giving a prototype to you. Public, here is the return type, maybe like model amount, model and view object, comma, maybe, or you can take it, maybe, comma, or you can use all, or like, string or like void. Okay, you can take it. And name is action name. Which action you want to perform with the particular method and use. Here you pass the one HTTP request HTTP servlet request and servlet response. Servlet request and comma, you can use comma, HTTP servlet response. Okay. And this is the prototype, guys. This one is multiple. Now this is the prototype. Return type may be model and view object and string and void. It depends on our requirement, guys. It depends on totally our requirement, guys. So this is the prototype. The important. This is the prototype, guys. So now example, how we can write this method and all the things I'm just writing for the example. Example. Just I'm writing and same thing I will use inside the project. Example. So now here is create one user defined class, suppose public. I'm creating one user defined class public. Create one user defined class, okay? Public class. Suppose I want to insert a student record, okay? Student record, you can take a student record, employee record, and movie sticker, and whatever you want, you can insert it, okay? By using this, I will use one structure, I will use one. Like DO part, okay, DTO part also I believe. Okay. But just I'm giving idea how I will use this thing. So now here, just I created class controller. Class, suppose a student controller. Otherwise take employee. Employee is good. Employee controller. So I want to insert employee data, retrieve employee data, and delete employee data and update employee data. So these four actions I want. So now here extend multi action controller. Okay, simple. So now here, inside this, provide how many actions you require. Just I want to public add means I want to add the employees. So I want to return model and view. I want to return add method. This is the HTTP. Servlet request, comma, HTTP servlet response RES, okay, and throws the exception. Now here provide some add related logics. Here you can provide some add related logics. Okay. Now same thing happened with the like search employee. Okay. Search employee, I want to just return the model and view object. Same. You can use, it depends on your project requirement. When I will develop, then I will show you. Okay, search, same thing. Okay. Paste it, search and update action. You can say method or here public like delete employee. You really want to develop this application by using this? Okay, I will do. Don't worry, employee. Now this is the user defined multi-action controller. Here, how many actions we have? Here we have four actions. Add actions is there. Okay. Update is there and delete is there. So now, if Spring has not provided the multi-action controller, then you should write all the controllers separately. This is the header. That's why given by the multi-action controller Spring framework. Okay. now righted some points about the multi-action controller. So how multi-action controller will execute, how we pass all these things, I will show you how we can configure these thing inside the configuration file. So how, let's write it. To trap all requests to the multi-action controller class and to execute action methods, we have to use what is that? Name attribute and value in bean configuration in spring configuration file. So now how we can provide it like this, we can suppose name equals to just take what is that, take as slash name and class you can take com dot, I created itsp dot controller dot employee controller. Okay. So now my question is how you can call this controller's particular method. So we have one thing. How we can call, I'm giving some idea about you. Suppose localhost slash colon 2021, suppose this is the port number, and slash application multi-action application name is, my application name is application contact path name is multi-action controller approach project and slash just call same. That it. This is the way localhost. Yeah, this is the localhost HTTP. You can add it. Not an issue. Not a big thing. Now we can call by using this thing. So we can call save, delete, update like that. So manually you can call like delete, save is not there. Other that add and search, paste. Update, paste, and delete. Delete that. So these things you can call. So now writing this about this point related to these in the above context, If we submit, suppose I submit which one? This one. This request I submitted. This request I submitted to the submitted then shape method in controller action class controller action class will be executed similarly search update delete okay all search update and delete method will be executed as per the URI values from client. Okay. From the client, like search update project. So this is total about our multi-action. This is the point and this is all the thing. Now I am giving a project ID to giving project ID. But be prepared. Just we prepared one action. Just we prepared one form. First orally, I'm giving to you. Here it's good. Okay. So now this is the home.jsp. Home.jsp. Okay. Inside this, I'm just giving some hyperlinks. I will give some hyperlink. Suppose add employee. Okay. Search employee. Okay. And update employee. And delete employee. Employee. These hyperlink I'm giving on the home.jsp when our application executes first time. These hyperlink will come. And after the hyperlink, when you click on this hyperlink, like add employee, when you click on the hyperlink, suppose add employee. Then one form will open. Just giving an idea, okay? Yeah. One form will open, guys. One form is open. And inside the form, one day some fields are there, like this form is registration.jsp or add employee.jsp page. Okay, otherwise take add form is good. Add form.jsp. Some database operation it will perform. So now when you perform this, then you will get this. So now here some fields are there. Suppose employee ID. Okay. Employee name, just simple property I am giving, and employee address, and click one button. I will provide one button. Okay, so now this is the form, and yes, we add one button. This button is add. Button is add. What is that button? Is add. When you click this button, then data will added. Data will added. Okay. Now next is, next button is when you, like when you click on search, when you click on search, one form will appear. One form, but a small form. I will just giving this property, don't worry. My cursor is okay. Inside this form, just enter employee ID. Employee ID. When you enter the employee ID, here inside this field. Okay, here I'm providing one more button. Inside the button, I'm providing just search. This is our project idea and this is our UI part. So UI part is the important, guys. UI part is the important, okay? Once we develop one module, like add module and the value module are the same, not that much. Only one module is it's taking some more time, like update module. Okay, why? Because the data is already there and getting the data and updating the data. Okay, so when you get this, when you click on update, now here, when you guys click on update, then one form will appear. Okay, just giving this name. Wait. I'm giving this. So this is the search form. Search form.jsp, guys. Search form. This is a multi-XM controller. That's why I'm taking. If you have a patience, then you can watch. If you don't have patience, just leave it. Okay. I'm not saying you are watching my videos. Just leave it. You don't have any patience to learn something. So just leave it here. Not an issue. When you click, like when you pass here, you can enter employee ID. Employee ID. This is the update, na? Update. Suppose you entered the employee ID. Now this is not a search, guys. Here, this is not search. Don't think this is search, guys. Okay. Here. Just here, click on get added. Get added form. What is that? Get added form. When you click on this button, guys, one form will get. Okay. What is the form? Added form, guys. Okay. Added form. So now this form is, name is, I'm just giving update form. updateform.jsp. Just I'm giving the name. Okay. Now when you hit the get added button, one form will open with better to take not this one. Okay. Not an issue. Same form. Just data is same form we get. Okay. Just I will change the name. Okay. This form is added to form. What is that? Add it. Add it form dot JSP. Add it form the JSP. So now here, instead of add, just provide the update. Okay, just provide the update. Okay. Here, S1 is the, I will provide, so ID is should not be changed. Okay, should not be changed, should not be updated. So ID is the fixed. So I will fix the ID by using some tag, like fixed tag. The HTML is there and tag is there. So we can fix the IDs. Suppose here, employee ID is there. 101. So ID 101 is same. Here enter ID 101. Then click on get edit form. Then 101. Suppose Raja is there. Raja is already there. So Raja is there. And Raja address is there, Delhi. Okay, Delhi is DL. I want to update 101 employee. 101 employee is to, what is that with the data? The updated value wise, suppose Raja, Rama. Update Rama, and instead of Delhi, I'm passing here. Instead of the I am passing a UP. Then you can get the update button, then you will get success message, other thing. So next is last one. This form is interact with the direct our multi action controller phase. Okay, this form data. Okay, when you click on add button, then add button interact with our multi action controller, go into the proprietor. I will also give. This is the UI part. Okay. So now come here. This is our delete form. Delete form same as this one. With the change name. So now here, just okay. Now here, instead of search, provide delete. Okay, this is not a search form, guys. This is not search form. This is. Delete form dot JSP. Okay. So now this is our UI part, guys. UI part. This is our hyperlink, guys. This is our hyperlink. Just time you do it. This is our hyperlinks. Okay. This is our hyperlink, guys. So now these form I will prepare, and also I will prepare some logics. Okay. So can I start preparing of this example? Okay. So requirement. Just I'm giving the requirement to you guys. What is the requirement for this application? First of all, you install in your system database is requirement. Requirement. Just I'm giving the requirement. Requirement to develop this application. What is the requirement? So now first is the Oracle database should install in your system. First is the requirement, and Eclipse is the required. Second one, the Eclipse any version you can use, and third one I will use Spring 5.x jars. I will 5.x jars. So now jars is the very, very important jars and listing. Just I am giving a list to you so you can understand what is the jar, how many jars. So now first is requirement is OJDBC 6 jar, OJDBC 6 dot jar file. And first jar is this one, and second jar is related to commons commons-logging jar. Okay, commons logging. Number third is Spring AOP is required. Number fourth is Spring aspect. Can you use Spring AOP? Aspect is required. Okay, any version you can use it, it's not an issue. But use a 4.x. You can use 4.x is better. Because 4 point is supporting more, like JDK 8, up to 4 points supporting. JDK 8 and 11. Okay, it's some compatibility issue may be there. So that's why you better to use above the 4 version, above the 4.x version. Okay, so I will use 4.x. We can also use this one, don't worry. Spring aspect is required, and Spring bean. Now, one more thing is Spring beans. The jars in there, I will use Maven beans. Okay. Now, sixth one is Spring context. Yeah, Spring context is required. Now, seventh jar file is Spring. Context support. Now eighth one is Spring Core. I didn't write it out. Good. Spring Core is required. Number ninth is why? Because I will use Spring expansion. Expansion jars is required. Number 10th is, nth number jar is Spring JDBC. I will use Spring JDBC concept. Now 11, now you can also learn in this single example, you can learn Spring JDBC concept. So now Spring transaction is required. Transaction is required. Spring, I want transaction TX, okay? And regular use jars Spring MVC, okay. And 13 is required. Which one jar is required? Web MVC. Spring hyphen web MVC. Now up to that, it's I think I routed all the jars. I list out, I think, so all jars. Those jars we required in our project, guys. Yes, I think. These jars we required. These jars we required. One is one or two missing. Right? First and second, we missed out. What is the first jar? And 11th jar, Spring transactions and Spring, okay, not issue, I'm doubted here. So now first jar is guys, first jar is to that OJDBC 6, na? 6, OJDBC 6 jar. Okay, OJDBC. Now, and 12 number is spring transaction is required in spring web, spring higher one, web is required, and 13 is last one, spring iPhone web MBC is required. So these jars is required. So next session, when I starting develop next sessions, I will first develop, I will use Maven. Number fourth requirement is Maven. Okay. So this is the requirement for us. Okay. So next session we will develop this application. Okay. If you have still any doubt related to this, you can mail me. My mail is javaysbk. You can find it. Otherwise, go on my Facebook page, just like it, and join with the group. Send me the request, I will accept. Then you can allow and share your doubt also. So, thank you. We will meet next sessions.